So where's this coming? Where's this coming?
Thank you. their husband, and the rest as we celebrate his life. Father, we give you praise.
Hallelujah.
Kingdom greetings, everyone. Oh, good morning, everyone. Hallelujah. At Kingdom Restoration International, we say Kingdom greetings because we greet you from the place where we live, all right? Hallelujah. It's a blessed morning to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. I know it's a homegoing service for Patrick Mothers, but the Word of God instructs us that we are to bless the Lord at all times, and His praises to continually be in our mouths. So this morning, we're going to lift the name of Jesus higher. We're going to give the King of Kings all of the glory that He so rightfully deserves. Amen? Hallelujah. Father, we bless your holy name. Lord, you are good, and your mercy endures for all generations. Hallelujah. We worship you.
Lord, you are good and your mercy.
next to me. Address, yes? So, what I would share with you real quick is that the memory just came to me.
Father,
I called him
and so much more.
Address, yes? So,
after that, I never.
What I would share with you real quick is that. The memory just came to me.
Father,
I called him
and so much more.
The dress, yes? So,
after that, I never.
What I would share with you real quick is that. The memory just came to me.
Father,
I called him
and so much more.
The dress.
A smile. Thank you so much. In the interest of time, we
ask. So after that, I never. What I would share with you real quick is that the memory just came to me.
Father,
I called him
and so much more.
Nobody. I see a smile. Thank you so much. In the interest of time, we ask.
So after that, I never. What I would share with you real quick is that the memory just came to me.
Father,
I called him
and so much more.
Nobody. I see a smile. Thank you so much. In the interest of time, we ask.
So after that, I never.
What I would share with you real quick is that.
The memory just came to me.
Father,
I called him
and so much more.
I see a smile. Thank you so much. In the interest of time, we ask.
So after that, I never.
What I will share with you real quick is that. The memory just came to me.
Father,
I called him
and so much more.
I see a smile. Thank you so much. In the interest of time, we ask. So after that, I never.
What I will share with you real quick is that.
The memory just came to me.
Father,
I called him
and so much more.
I see a smile. Thank you so much. In the interest of time, we ask. So after that, I never.
What I will share with you real quick is that.
The memory just came to me.
Father,
I called him
and so much more.
I see a smile. Thank you so much. In the interest of time, we ask. So after that, I never.
What I will share with you real quick is that.
The memory just came to me.
Father,
I called him
and so much more.
I see a smile. Thank you so much. In the interest of time, we ask.
So after that, I never.
What I will share with you real quick is that.
The memory just came to me.
Father,
I called him
and so much more.
Why Why do ye persecute me as God, and are not satisfied with my flesh? Oh, that my words were now written, oh, that they were printed in a book, that they were driven with an iron pen and led in a rock forever. For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And through my skin, wounds destroy his body. Yet in my flesh, I shall see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and not another through the reins be consumed within me. But he should say, why persecute me? Be him, seeing the root of the matter is found in me. Be ye afraid of the sword, for wrath bringeth the punishments of the sword, that he may know there is a judgment. This is the word of the Lord.
Amen.
Thank you very much. I invite you to stand at this time as we'll be led to sing the hymn, Amazing Grace.
Amen.
will read, who will share the eulogy with us. Mrs. Jamila and siblings.
Good morning, all. Thank you all for coming here today. We'll not read the eulogy now. It's prepared by myself, Mona, and Shari. Just some of the remembrance of my dad. For you today. So, losing our dad was one of the hardest things that we have had to face. As we stand in here today, we realize how fortunate we were to have as a father, you know. There's no really words to express his influence in our life, and we'll get to that eventually. So even though he may not have said it out loud, I know he was truly proud of each and every one of us and the way we grew up. The circumstances didn't really permit all of us to be to live together at the same time, but we still would find time to spend time together, whether it was Christmas or the holidays. We go to the beach, siblings and I would go to the mall, anything that we could have decided that was fun for us and we could have afforded to go at that time. He was always there for everybody, family, neighbors, colleagues, friends. You know, he was somebody you could call on. He was definitely a proud grandfather, to my nephew and the one son, Elam, who sits at the front row. He'd always try to be there for him and treat him special in any way, the way that he could. Always would be posting Elam and always talking about Elam and how proud of how proud he is of you. So. Our dad was an especially clean person. You know, he took kindness a little bit to the serious side. He always encouraged us to keep a clean household and surroundings. And he would never, you know, forget to remind you. He loved his cars. He also kept them as clean as possible. You know, almost spotless. I actually don't think I've ever remembered eating in his car, not one time. The one thing that he loved to do was lying. If you know my father, he would lie until the end of the dance, singing to the top of his lungs. He was a very entertaining person, and he's well known to many people, as you can see today with this resounding audience at the church. So thank each and every one of you. I will just go through some of the things that my personal experience with him, seeing that I lived with him for the majority of the three of us here. So I just want to go through a couple of things that my personal experience with him. You know, so there were good things and bad things. You know, so all of the good things I've said, you know, he was no saint by any means. I'm pretty sure that, you know, some people may have some complaints. But it's fine, you live and you learn and you forgive, right? You know, most times, hopefully before it's too late. He always encouraged me to wake up early, you know, whether it be by force or not. I guess you all know what that means. Always make sure I show up on time and make that extra effort to drop me on the bus with a maxi or to drop me to school while I was in primary school and secondary school. You know, he always encouraged me to work hard and study hard, you know, and I will reap the rewards eventually. He would repeatedly urge me to continue my studies at home so I could reach new heights. But, you know, I was more focused on linemen, you know, trying to be more like my dad. He always encouraged me to move faster, make haste. That's his favorite term, make haste. You know, he always wanted us to be quick and decisive. He was very stern as well, you know. He would never accept what he thought was acceptable. The way that he handled certain situations may have not been the most suitable, but in theory, he always stood up for what he believed in. Friendship, being friendly, laughing, smiling, having a good time. If you know my father, that are some of the main words you can use to describe him. You know, he was definitely life of the party, and through this, I also met some lifelong friends and family along the way. Some of which I see today, and I'm very thankful that each and every one of you are here today. He would always introduce me to his friends whenever possible. Some of us still remain close to us to and I thank each and every one of you. As my brother said, my father was at Lima. He was part of many groups and activities. As you can see, the police, the SC79, at St. Augustine, and many groups that you see here today would be part of the group singing, whether it's playing sports or, you know, karaoke, just sitting and drink. He really enjoyed being in the company of his friends. And you will see in some of the videos, whether it's on the screen or on Facebook. I'm very thankful for the ways in which he has positively impacted my life. You know, while I rather would stray away from most of his many qualities that he has, but there's one that I can't shake, you know, and his love for his son of his love for some of his friends and family, and I truly appreciate each and everybody here today in whatever capacity, whether you even click the YouTube link. I am extremely grateful, and for all my friends that have been there for me throughout the journey, I'm proud of you and myself, and I'm very thankful, and I will never forget this period of time. You know, as I said just to close, we can't really imagine not having him here, you know, whether it's to just call him if it's a problem or whatever. You know, to say that we love him would have been an understatement. And we would miss him, truly miss him, you know. So thank you, everybody, for listening to us.
Thank you. We truly pray God's strength for his sons and his daughter and all the family members today. Amen. Amen. We will now have three members from Patrick's family to come to the mic at this time. And you know who you are? Yes? Three members of the family. As we continue to pay tribute to the so-called king, along with some of our friends, because of dress, yes, even his Africanness. So we will move right on to the groups that are here to speak about this dear friend of ours. We will ask that one member from the group, from each group, speak on behalf of their groups. And that would be St. Augustine, first batch, Police 79ers, and Customs Emancipation Group. Would you welcome them, please? In that order.
Pleasant morning, everyone. I am next to Prince. I am next to Prince. Alongside me is Ms. Paula Rose Pumel. We are both former school classmates and friend of Patrick, aka Monico, Patos, Dan Daddy, Mr. Dimples. We represent the St. Augustine Senior Secondary School, the Green Machine, first batch group, class of 1977. We have been asked to say a few brief words on our association with Patrick. I personally have known Patrick for the better part of 55 years. We grew up in Hoover, and we attended the exchange RC primary school in Cuba. Then proceeded to the Cuba Junior Secondary School after common entrance in 1972. We were not in the same class in junior secondary, but this did not diminish the friendship forged from primary school. That bond remained solid and intact. At school, Patrick was quiet, reserved, and a private person. He never spoke much about his immediate family. He said only what was needed to be known. His father was a strict disciplinarian, his mother a deeply religious woman. In 1975, we entered the St. Augustine Senior Secondary School, a school where lasting friendships were formed and continued up to this day. Most of us from that batch are present here today, giving evidence. We were part of a crew from the Cuba, California area that rode and controlled the bus that transported us to school daily, the California bus. If at that time we told the driver or conductor not to stop for that person, they listened. They had to get us our stamp of approval before they can ride in that bus. We were not bullies, eh? We were just having fun at that time at school. That daily bus commute at school brought many of us closer together, and we looked out for each other. At lunchtime, we all came together under a train to school grounds, where we all shared in each other's lunches. We all looked forward to his mother's pot pie. She couldn't make a good pot pie. He was an avid supporter of any sporting activity the school teams was involved in, and was always in the forefront of the cheering section. He had a voice for that. His popularity grew, especially with the ladies. His dimples was the melting pot. I cannot say that I ever saw him angry. If he was, he hid it well. He always greeted you with a smile. After secondary school, everyone ventured into their respective career path, and contact was lost for a while. But whenever he could have, he never hesitated in stopping by and checking in with his former neighbors and friends. That was the measure of the man he was. He was humble and polite, and never forgot where he came from or the people he knew. He was upright and always neatly dressed, militant looking. So it came as no surprise that he would follow his father's footsteps in that profession as a police officer. He was trustworthy, a dependable person who was always there to assist or give support. He always advocated for and sought to keep friendships alive and to develop a bond of togetherness. He always said that life was too precious and fragile and should be enjoyed to the max, and this he did. He always said too as well that unity was strength, that we needed people around us to make us smile and to feel alive. It was in this mindset that he became instrumental in joining with other former first batch students, Merlin, Paula, Lionel, Pat, Renette, Katian, to form this powerful group, Green Machine, first batch, class of 1977.
Good morning. My name is Paula, I'm Miss Brunner. Patrick was a long life friend of mine. I expected that we would still be lining and supporting each other well in old age. And so, his sudden passing was as much a shock to me as it was his family and the many people who knew and loved him. I first met Patrick when we were attending St. Augustine Senior Comprehensive in the class of 1975 to 1977. I remember him being a neat and orderly but naughty teenager. He was always harassing the girls and other students. We lost contact for a while after school until we met up in 1999 and stayed in touch from there on. I remember him coming to custom sporting events and to different lines and parties that I was involved in. And eventually, he became an invaluable part of customs emancipation events and tournament. We traveled together with a sporting team from customs, and even when I left, he continued. Later, he was introduced to the Sound Noisemakers Rhythm Section, where he played an integral part, singing and playing all the instruments. He stayed there as well. And during COVID, when we launched Green Machine first batch, he was an administrator. And of course, as a former member of the police force, he was also a part of the police group, the 79ers. That was the thing about Patrick. He was loyal and committed to community and to his friends. We could always count on Patrick to support our groups and all initiatives that our causes, not just with his presence, but whatever resources he had. I remember him buying a Bluetooth speaker box, and he would use that to play music and sing and to whatever entertainment that he could have us happy. In fact, he loved singing so much that wherever there was karaoke, he would make himself available. It could be in Point 40 in Mayawa, Tobago. Patrick will be there. Patrick was also an enterprising and hardworking person. He invested in a pickup truck and provided transport services for my company and others. He also rented cars and did power washing. He was surely an entrepreneur, always creating new ways to generate income. I believe that everyone who knew Patrick would remember him as a loving and supportive person who loved to be around people and spend time with his friends. Of course, he knew he would always do well. Patrick was always a neat and clean person, particularly when it came to his personal appearance and his vehicle, and he liked to be on time. If Patrick was picking you up to go somewhere and you were late, you would get left behind. But all these things just rounded out his personality and made us love him more. He was fully and wholeheartedly himself, and he brought that energy to every gathering and every line and in every interaction. Patrick, my friend, you will be missed. And this is coming from also not even the Green Machine alumni, your first batch, but also the Green Machine alumni, which he was also administrator, part of the Green Machine alumni. Thank you, everyone.
Very pleasant morning to all. AP, district, elders, senior persons of the retired police association, 79ers, friends and well-wishers, a pleasant morning to all. I am representing the 79ers, that's the first batch, A-F, of police officers who entered the police training college on the 17th of April, 1979. When we entered, we were placed into squads, senior squads, ABC, DEF, junior squads. Patrick was placed in the C squad. I too, my bed lay alongside Patrick's bed, just to the left hand of him. So for almost 8 months, I slept adjacent to Patrick. Patrick's mother's parents religiously brought him meal in the afternoon, which he religiously shared with us, and we look forward to it every day, those of us who didn't have people bringing things for us. Patrick's parents, what we in our batch came to understand, were very strict and religious persons. That foundation remained in Patrick up to recently. This batch stayed together until they retired, and after retirement, we still stayed together, celebrating 44 years. I want to be short. What I want to share with you all, though, is our experience on the weekend of April 17th, where we all traveled to Tobago to celebrate our 44th anniversary. Patrick was most present. Those of us could remember him coming up on the boat and also going back down on the boat. What is most touching about this thing, though, folks, is that we attended a service this Sunday at the Moray River Church, and Patrick sang at that church, and I could hear him singing now. Patrick could sing, boy, I have a good voice. And he touched all at church that day, all of us. After the service, we had a wonderful lunch, and if you saw Patrick, you know that nothing was wrong with him. If you compare him to any of our batches, he looked buff, looked like in his early 40s, looked great. And you all just think about our experience that we had with Patrick at the beach, playing on fours, different activities that we participated in on that weekend. Most of us see us here in the scholarship. We were all present there, and that experience, I will tell you, and to hear of his passing, it's unbelievable. Many of us sitting down here today still can't believe that is Patrick there. So my message to the church today and to my batches, after you cross a certain age, look out for your health. Take care of your body. You know that the scriptures say that your body is the temple of God. Take care of your health. And more so to my batches who are all retired, over 60, we too don't know who is next. Trust God, pray to God, and as I close, condolences to Patrick's children. I know how you all are feeling too. And we say one of our motto is to take care of our own, and we would be looking out for you all. Trust me, if there's anything you all are in need of, please, just a phone call away. We have a PRO, Mr. Richardson. Just reach out to him and we will take care of you. Trust God, and condolences to all friends and family. Thank you for this opportunity.
Trust God, pray to God, and look out for your own. Excellent, excellent advice. Do we have a representative from the San Juan noisemakers? Is that you? Customs? Exactly. I just made all my belonging. I'm so sorry. You good?
Celebration Committee, a member of the Sports and Cultural Club of the Customs and Excise Division, team member, manager, friend of our dearly beloved. I am standing here with my boss, also a member, a valid member of the Customs and Excise Emancipation Celebration Committee, touring team, sports to Caribbean tournament, touring team. You would have heard other persons speaking about the touring team. And so you're looking at a lot of pictures from us on tournament. In this household of faith, I see flags representing various nations, and I'm sure Patrick has a friend in each one of these countries, because I also bring great tidings for persons from Antigua, St. Lucia, the British Virgin Islands, and many others of our Caribbean counterparts. It is very strange how pathways cross, and we end up meeting people who will leave a resounding memory in our hearts and mind a long time afterwards. The only thing is that when it is happening, you do not expect it to have that profound effect. This is the sentiment I am here to convey today. On behalf of the Customs and Excise Emancipation Celebration Committee and Performing Group, and the Customs and Excise Sports Club Tournament Team, I became acquainted with Patrick somewhere back in 2007-2008, after joining the Customs Emancipation Group, of which I am a team leader. At that time, I found out that Patrick had started out as an invitee to our group rehearsals just one day, and he became a treasured member ever since. He never left. As a loved and cherished member of our emancipation and social family in the Customs and Excise Division, nothing could happen without Patrick being there. I remember having a quiet chat with Patrick as we reminisced on some of our stage performances. And I recall him saying, "Clinis, I always wanted to be affiliated with a good thing." And he had discovered value in the efforts of our group, comprising of staff members and our families, trying to commemorate and celebrate emancipation while educating our audiences through the performing arts and culture. He was a member of our choir. He was a soloist. He tried his hand as a model of African fashions and never declined to make a contribution to our performing exploits. As a stage buddy, he was always positive and ready to work. Our artistic director, Curtis Ross, and other tutors admired his humility, his talent, and good sense of humor, as he was a go-with-the-flow kind of guy, happy-go-lucky. No matter the drama, he would not let it derail him. He was well admired by our Caribbean counterparts during Easter tournament, and was the guy with the golden voice for the karaoke talent segments. Patrick was a member of our tournament pistol shooting team in Guyana in 2017. Some of the pictures are on show with all the team members as we would have shot on the range there. Condolences were shared by members of the St. Lucia, British Virgin Islands, Guyana, and Antigua team members on hearing of his passing. His good tournament buddy is now stationed in Brussels, and was very sad this morning when she called me to say she's very, very heartbroken that she was not able to be here in Trinidad and Tobago. On a personal note, it touched me to say that Patrick never hesitated to make the journey when it mattered the most. I remember him coming to my hometown, deep in South Trinidad, in Santa Flora Palo Seco, on learning of my mother's death during COVID time in 2021, just to give me the reassurance that everything will be okay. He was one of the very first persons, as soon as we walked out of that church, to say, "Glynis, God has got you. Everything will be okay." And strangely enough, first, everybody knows Patrick, or knew Patrick, That day I found out he was my big brother's friend from the police choir and La Petite Musicale, the gentleman who's with the camera snapping, police photographer McLean. That day I discovered that. We acknowledge that Patrick was human and may not have been Superman, although he looked dandy and super. The Lord has chosen to call him home now, and we thank Almighty God for sharing this lovely soul with us. Let us live right, forgive ourselves and others, and keep living prayerfully, remembering Patrick's laughter and resolute tones as he belted out his songs, "She's Royal" and "The Goodness of God." Sleep in peace, rise in glory, my friend and our brother and our friend. Condolences to his siblings, his loved ones, and all those he has shared special moments with. Thanks be to God.
Thank you, Venice. It was through Venice that I would have met Patrick, and she invited me to share so many customs and excise emancipation programs. I don't recall her saying that he also danced, did you? I remember seeing him dance as well. We will now close off the tributes by inviting members of the 79ers to do a presentation to Patrick's sons and daughters. This is a final request for a representative from the San Juan Noisemakers Rhythm Section. Is there anybody here to represent that group? Okay. So without further ado, I would like to invite Shadi Modeste to share in song. Shadi?
Good morning, everyone. Thanks for coming. Thanks for staying strong with us. Even the first song I'm going to sing is a song that my brother requested I sing, that he loves. And I'm going to sing the last song he sang, which is that. Now I heard there was a secret chord that David played to please the Lord, but you don't really
Yeah. How many of you were there? Yeah, I saw the shirts. I saw a particular lady wear some. sincere condolences to his daughter and sons. And we just get to know each other, just have to get to know each other better, that's it. And sometimes one thing will happen for other things to take place and flow. And I just thank God for the opportunity, to the entire MODESTE family, friends and well-wishers and those online. Truly I express my condolences today. I know what it is to suffer loss. Many that I've loved, I have lost my both parents within 9 months of each other. It's fascinating. My dad went to them, my mom went 9 months after, so while you're trying to get over the grief, and let me say something to the children. Don't let anyone tell you how to grieve. There are times when you will not be able to stop crying, and there are times when you would laugh, when you remember the memory, and you know, as you were talking about, you know, his both sides, and then the other side, and nobody else knows. But we all have those sides. We all look great at times, and then at times we don't. We all sound great at times, and at times we don't. It's just something that we're all working on until we come to a place where we look like him, where his image shines forth through us. And my cousin and I reconnected when he visited our assembly, Kingdom Restoration International, at the corner of Baltazar Street in Tunapuna. I'm not advertising, or am I? Corner of Baltazar Street, Eastern Main Road in Tunapuna. And he came, and he was coming there for about a year, on and off, and he was telling me about his birthday as usual, and of course how good he was looking, and I had to agree. He was good to look at, and he was very good looking. We did have something in common. Let me see if you have it there, Shadi. We do have, yeah, I'm just saying. So, no offense to all the other cousins, but I was his favorite dimple cousin. And so we had fun when we were able to. So I thank God for the opportunity to stand here today. But today I want to talk to the living, because he can't hear me. There isn't anything I can say to him, or any amount of love I can pour out to him right now for him to be able to feel, to experience. But for us who are here, alive and breathing, we can still hear. We can still give God the opportunity to do what he does best, is to take care of his own. I want to look at a topic today, which is very, very interesting. The subject I chose is, don't be caught dead without Jesus. No pun intended. In all respect, that's due. But I'm here to tell those of us that are breathing, don't be caught dead without Jesus. And I'm looking at an account, state Luke chapter 16, verses 19 to 31. I will go through quickly, and I would literally speak in between the verses so that in the interest of time, you can leave here. I also want to give you an opportunity as you hear the word of God to allow him to consume your heart and your mind, and for you to adhere to what he is saying to us today through his vessel. So Father, I thank you for the opportunity to speak. I thank you for being used as your oracle, O God. Let your word go forth, and according to what is written, it shall not return unto you void. So have your divine way through your Son, Jesus the Christ, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, we agree and we say amen and amen. Luke chapter 16, verses 19 to 31. It's an account about a rich man and Lazarus. And some of you may have heard of this before. It doesn't matter what you've heard before. Once you're hearing it again, there is something in the word of God that you still need to flesh out. There is something in the word of God that you still need to be reminded of. And for those of you who've never heard it, listen attentively, because God has something to say to you today. Praise the name of the Lord. I didn't bring my amen choir with me, but if the word touches you, don't be afraid. Nobody's going to put you in handcuffs. Feel free to praise God. Amen. Amen. Verse 19, it starts by saying, there was a certain rich man who was clothed in purple and fine linen and fared sumptuously every day. But through this parable, confronts his audience and highlights the journey of eternal destiny. And I want us to pay attention to this. He was addressing those living in the time about being conscious
you're going to die and then that's the end. There is more. There is always more. What am I saying? Don't be caught dead without Jesus. Verse 24 says, and when he cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me and send Lazarus that he may dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am in torment in this flame. But Abraham said, son, remember that in your lifetime you received your good things, just like many here today. And likewise, Lazarus, evil things. But now he is comforted and you are tormented. It's important that we realize that we are not perfect. We are yet to get to that state of maturity, understanding. So I want to plug this in. Don't judge others by what you know or don't know about them. Look unto thy own self. Someone very famous says, you should look at the man in the mirror. The name Lazarus is derived from the Hebrew Eliza, meaning God has helped. God helped Lazarus. Although his life didn't look good from an earthly perspective, he entered into eternity with God. Imagine dogs licking you, licking your womb, and yet still, you end up in the bosom of Abraham, and in the presence of God. A brief eulogy of both men was given by the only one who was able to speak about them with accurate judgment. I assure you, if you die without Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, it will be the worst mistake possible that you can make. If you have not received Jesus as Lord and Savior, and I'm unashamed about this, I am here to say to you, this is the day, this is the hour, this is the moment to receive him as Lord and as Savior. I hope I was clear, because I didn't mean to stutter. Don't be caught dead without Jesus. You don't really hear words like this again. People preaching salvation and talking about sin and hell and the word of laws. And I'm not here to offend any other religion. I'm just very, very excited, happy, and proud to call on the name of Jesus. He works for me. He's my Lord and my Savior. Verse 29 says, Abraham said to him, they have Moses and the prophets, let them hear. I'm here to remind somebody, don't be caught dead without Jesus. Don't let anyone convince you that when you die, it will be over. According to the word of God in Hebrews 9:27, it says, and as it is appointed unto man once to die, but after death is judgment. And this is what is going to happen after death. Revelations 20:15 says, and whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. I want to say that again. And whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. Listen to me, folks. The time to repent and receive Jesus as Lord and Savior is now. Don't put it off for another day. Don't put it off for another minute or another second. The time is now. And those of you who have already received him as Lord and Savior, if you know you're not accurately aligned with him and you're not walking the way you should walk, then this is a good day for reconciliation. This is a good day to repent and come back home. This is a good day for the backsliders to return. I don't know who I'm talking to. You, maybe I'm just talking to everybody, or maybe myself, but somebody gotta hear the word that Jesus Christ is Lord. He died and he rose again, and he's coming back for his own. Verse 30 says, and he said, no, Father Abraham. He said, no, Father Abraham. Verse 30, but if one goes to them from the dead, they will repent. Now here is this man begging that he can go back, or at least send Abraham to tell others about he was in. He wanted just one more chance to tell his five siblings, get it right. Don't come here in this place. Because it's a place of torment and flames. And there was nothing he could have done at that time. I don't want him to hear me after I'm gone. I want him to take heed today while I'm yet breathing. I've known Jesus as my Lord and Savior for many years, and I've had my own ups and downs, but I thank God in the midst of chaos, in the midst of adversity, I can still stretch out and call out to Him. He is my help. Where my help coming from? My help comes from the Lord, and I'm here today to say to you, your help comes from the Lord. I'm not here to judge anybody. I'm just here to tell you the good news about Jesus, that He's really, He's able. I'm moving this out to open wide to receive you today. Today is the day of salvation. This man wanted one more chance. He said, if you could just dip your finger. Just dip. It's so bad down here. If I could just get just a tip. And then he cried out for those that he was to try and cool him down of the torment, and he was begging if he could have gotten one more chance to tell his siblings that there is a place called hell and he don't want them to join him, and he wanted to ask to go on, and there's a place called heaven, a place where he can be in the bosom of God, a place of safety, a place of hope, a place where there is no pain, no sickness, no sorrow. But he didn't get another chance. All we have is now. I'm talking to you now just as Patrick was singing one weekend, and now we are viewing him. I want to be looked at rather than viewed. You can look at me now, but please, I can't do nothing. If you're viewing my body, so it can happen. We don't know. We behave as though we know, because we are good. We have this plan. We have this in place. We have our wealth. And listen to me. I'm not against wealth at all. As a matter of fact, if some of you want to bring some for me today, I'm taking it. I'm just saying. Because sometimes we get it a little twisted. I'm not talking about it. I'm talking about you can have all that you have. But the ultimate is having Jesus in your heart. Receiving Him as Lord and Savior. That's the ultimate. So this man, having gone through what he went through and what he was going through, reached out for one more chance. And his request was denied. Don't wait until you reach a stage where your request is denied. Right now, anything you say to God right now will be granted. Come into my heart. Lord, Savior, forgive me. I repent. He is going to do it, but when that time comes, there's nothing you can say or do to change your circumstance. John 3:16 clearly says, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have what? Everlasting life. You see, you really should live now, but you should not live now as though there's no then. Because after now is then. So you gotta live with the understanding that now is all you have. Live now and prepare for then. Are you with me, somebody? I wish the believers would lift their voices and let those who need to come to Christ know that I'm not standing here alone. That they believe and God works for them. I told someone simply, he's like, why do you believe in this God? And he's like, oh, this is trouble happening, and all this is there, and people dying, COVID, and blah, blah, blah. I said, He works for me. My belief in Him, my faith in Him works. functions, this level of functionality. What I need to do is continue to align myself accurately. I stand here not as a perfect being, but God knows my heart, I'm striving toward that. And every time I slip, every time I might have a blunder, I can still call on Him. Why? Because I'm still breathing and I'm still here on earth. This is the platform for us, the opportunity for us to repent, the opportunity for us to make it right. And we're not looking for perfect beings today. We're looking for hearts that are willing to be all that God wants them to be. Time is short in comparison to eternity. Eternity is not governed by time. Are you with me, somebody? Jesus died so you might live. What am I saying? Don't be caught dead without Jesus. 2 Peter 3:9 says, the Lord not slack concerning his promises, as some count slackness, but is long-suffering towards us, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. You won't be able to make a decision about your destiny after death. Are you hearing me? Nor would you be able to have a positive impact on the lives of others. We can't hear a thing from Patrick. We can't even get help from him. Because that's it. We don't have to wait till we get to that stage. Especially none of us know when that time would be. Because 1 minute you're here, and next minute you're gone. The choices you make in your lifetime are projected into eternity. Therefore, fulfilling your purpose and reaching your destination being a goal, this will bring God glory and you will be lifted up. The time to think about dying is while you are still alive. What comes next is fixed. Are you hearing me? When you're dead, you can no longer think about how to live your best life. And I'm here to tell you, I know what it is to not have, and I know what it is to have. I know what it is to be abused as a young woman. I know what it is to grow up in poverty. I know what it is to be betrayed. I know what it feels like to be hated. And I know what it feels like to be hurt. But none of that which I just spoke of is enough, is powerful enough to keep me away from loving and serving the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. I will bear the pain and still call his name. I'm standing here and I'm trying to commit suicide. I don't even know how I'm going there, but I'm going to be shorter than this, I promise. It's about 2 more hours of wiggle. I know what it is to want to die. I attempted suicide 3 times. Most of my relatives don't have a clue about that. They just judge what they see now. Don't look at all this. I've been through my own stuff. And yes, I wanted to die. And I was trying to help with the process. But somehow God got a hold on me. And I was able, not understanding what I was doing, calling on Jesus, and he heard me. So I stand here today, unashamedly so, knowing that he's able not just to save, not just to heal, not just to keep, but he's able to love unconditionally. He is my Lord and Savior. And I invite you to make him yours. Hebrews 9:27 says, and as it is appointed for man to die once, but after death, after this, the judgment. The judgment. This is your day. This is your time. If God could turn my life around, if he He could do it for me, and he could do it for you. As long as I have breath, I will declare who my Jesus is. Because I don't know when he'll take me away. I just don't know. Do it before it's too late. Because when you cross over, nothing else you can do. Don't be caught dead without Jesus. I have a watch on my hand. It tells the time while we are here on earth. What I don't have in my hand is my breath. Right now I can tell you the time, but I don't know when this could stop. Because you have things to cause you to function in a certain way here on earth. It does not depict your reality when you die. The things are temporal. God is real and he is eternal. And I call on everyone today as we stand together. Let's all stand. Don't be caught dead without Jesus. Jesus loves you. I said, Jesus loves you. I want you to just come as you are. If you are here today, and I have to make this call, and I'll pray you take heed before it's too late. Some of you have been through a whole lot. Some of you, when the doctor gave you a bad report, you even missed it, you thought that was going to be it. Yes. But somehow you're here today looking at someone who didn't make it, but you are here. And I want to make this call with every fiber in my being. Holy Spirit, if you are here today and you don't know Jesus as Lord and Savior, just lift your hands, and we were just going to pray. If that's you, just lift your hands quickly. I see one hand. Can I see another hand? I see that hand in the back there. Thank you so much. Is there someone else? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What about those? If I see another hand, thank you. What about you who you don't know how you got to where you got to, but all you know, you need to get back in line, and you want that reconciliation to take place. Can I see your hand as well? Can I see your hand? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Can I ask those of you who lifted your hand, you're not too ashamed. I pray you're not. Let's come. Let's pray with you quickly. Just quickly. Just come quickly. To come as fast as you can. Hallelujah. See, this is, listen to me. Something about death is a reality check, and some people are ignoring it still, but I'm here to tell you today, this is your day. This is the opportunity. Just come right into the front. I want to have the honor and the pleasure, hallelujah, to stand in the midst of those God has called home, those that God are calling to repentance. If I could just have the ushers, and if there are any ministers here among us, hallelujah, hallelujah, glory be to God. I guess the rest of you are not ready just yet. Okay, come on now. Hallelujah. Those of you who know to pray, pray. Hallelujah. Come on, those of you who know to worship, continue worshiping him. Because as the last song that I heard Patrick singing was All My Life, You Have Been Faithful. All my life, you've been good. With every breath that I make, I will sing of the goodness of God. Just lift your hands. It's okay, let the tears flow, it's fine. See, we really don't know where that's what you want. We really don't know where. We don't even know what to say. Well, just leave us, we can listen to this prayer. Can we have take the mic and just do this? Because Patrick, you must have done something good. I know you can't hear me, but you must have done something good. Something good. In the midst of all the chaos, you must have done something good. If you could just have a mic on as your hands are lifted. Praise the name of the Lord. stand with your wife. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we praise you. We bless you. We exalt your name on high. And we lift you up, oh God. We declare that there is none like unto you. Hallelujah. The saints begin to pray on heaven is rejoicing. There is one soul for Jesus and two are reconciliating unto him. Hallelujah. One soul, lead him into prayer and then pray a general prayer for all. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
God, you are worthy to be
yes,
praised.
You are.
God, as they come before you this morning,
Jesus,
we ask that you take full control in their life,
Lord.
God, you saw this step they're making this morning, God.
Hallelujah.
They made that extra effort to God to come forth despite of whatever they're going through in their personal life, God.
Jesus.
They came forth and surrendering all to you, God. God, we thank you, oh God, for honoring, God. We thank you for keeping your promises. We thank you for renewal of commitment, oh God.
Jesus.
Even if they black sinned before, God, we thank you, God, for recommitment to you, God.
Yes.
We thank you for your word.
Yes, God.
For your promises. For they are true, yes and amen. But I just want you to repeat after me. Say, God, I recommit my life to you. Use me. In your name.
Accepted Jesus. It's your name. Felix, a former officer. You just joined the army of God. So we thank God for you. We thank God for you. And Father, even at this age, he has submitted his life to you. He's given his life over. And Father, we pray right now. Father, you just repeat after me. Heavenly Father, I repent before you through your Son, Jesus the Christ. And I ask of you, Jesus, to come into my heart. Take control of my life. I lay down my own ways and I submit my all to you. I ask of you, oh God, as you forgive me, that you would use me for your honor. And for your glory.
From this day forward.
Would live for you. From this day forward, I will submit to you. From this day forward, I will tell others about you. As I surrender my life to you. Today, God, I lay it all down and I say I belong to you. Here I am, Jesus. Accept me as your own. Accept me as your son. I surrender all. Praise the name of Lord. Somebody give God praise. Father, we thank you. We thank you for these souls. We thank you for reconciliation. We thank you for salvation. We thank you, oh God, for lifting up. We thank you they have accepted you, reconciled with you, and that they are still breathing. And they can do so, God. I thank you for them, God. I bless them in their coming out. And I bless them in their coming in. And I declare, oh God, you are God over their lives. And beside you, there is none other. Touch them like never before. Heal them where they need to be healed, oh God. And let them open their mouths and testify about your goodness all the days of their lives. Lift your voice and say, oh, and all my life you have been faithful. Somebody say, all my life
you have been so.
Just lift your hands.
Come on.
God, we just want a family to come, and that means the children and all related, the modest, just come and just gather around. Those of you who are here, so many people have to be online because it's a weekday, time off from work. So many of the relatives wanted to come in from the various countries, some of his friends as well. Some more modest and stuff. They're probably a bit shy, but I'm just reading all of you, but you're close enough, so we're going to. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, we truly thank you. If we could just have focus at this time as we pray for the strength of the family. Some I'm seeing for the first time. It's really a huge family. We all look good. I'm just saying. It's a beautiful family. Hallelujah. Okay, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we truly thank you. Like truly, truly thank you. That we can all stand here breathing. Sometimes we take it for granted. Sometimes we take it lightly. But God, today, we are truly grateful. We express our gratitude that we are alive. And although it can be a very sad experience for many, if not all, experiences of pain, agony, experiences of confusion, just can't understand certain things. And one person said to me, it was so sudden. And then I heard from the others that spoke today, their disbelief. But the same person that was standing and singing and on a boat and off a boat, and all of a sudden is in a coffin. But today, I declare that the modest family, by extension, those related, will be strengthened. I pray for your strength today. I pray, oh God, you said that your joy is our strength. For those who know you, your joy is our strength. And even for those who don't know you, I declare, oh God, somehow they would find it, oh God, to stand strong in this time. heart would become so cohesive, Father, and we will understand what family is really all about. And oh God, there would be love, there would be unity, there would be camaraderie, oh God. There would be a sense of alignment, oh Father. And oh God, we will lay aside criticism and judgment, and we would just learn to love each other unconditionally. God, let it be unto this family, the Modeste family, and by extension, the other families, oh God. I declare right now, Father, there would be a unity like never before, God, that we will take time to really get to know each other even more. I pray, oh God, for strength right now. Your peace that passes all understanding shall be our portion, Father, in the name of Jesus, especially the children and the grandson, oh God. I pray even right now that for the siblings, oh God, of Patrick as well. I pray, oh God, that the entire family will come together, oh God, in one. That oneness that is necessary for growth and for development. That oneness that is necessary to impact our community, oh God, our nation, our sphere. That oneness, oh God, that is necessary, oh God, so that your name would be lifted up. I declare right now wholeness and oneness, completeness. I declare over this family strength, peace, grace, oh God, joy in the midst of the sorrow. Joy, oh God, because you are our help. And where, oh God, our help comes from, it comes from you. So God, I also pronounce a blessing from the crown of their heads to the soles of their feet, that they will be blessed in their going out, blessed in their coming in. And now I say, we shall be blessed in our going out, and we shall be blessed in our coming in. Father, be it unto us according to your will, your plan, and your purpose. Patrick is gone. You've left us here for a purpose. On purpose, by purpose, with purpose. And I declare, purpose shall be fulfilled in the midst of it all. God, and we will all come to know you as Lord and Savior and serve you as a family, oh God. We will leave a legacy. We will leave a legacy. Be it unto us according to your will, according to your plan, and according to your purpose. This day is marked not as the day of the homegoing service only of Patrick's body, because he's no longer here, it is just his body, but a day where all of heaven rejoices, because out of this circumstance came a brand new life and reconciliation of two more. And out of this, oh God, we are able to meet and greet and build, begin to build relationship with longevity. So thank you for the opportunity. As we continue to breathe, we know we owe it unto you. All the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. We pray this prayer in no other name but the name that's above every other name, the name of Jesus the Christ. And by the power of the Holy Spirit, we all agree and we say, amen and amen. Give God praise, give him glory, and give him honor, because he deserves it. Strength to this family.
Rejoicing today indeed. Amen. Amen. We will now
Awesome. Awesome. Well done, Aiden. Yes, let's show him some appreciation. Well done. Well done. Well done. At this time, we will have the rite of commendation officiated by Apostle and with the following of the hymn, How Great Thou Art.
All right, praise God. There's been a slight change in the program. Dr. B.M. Sinat will do the rite after cemetery, so from here we will do that. What we would like at this time, while the song is being played, is the vote of thanks. Shade would come. Shade Modeste. I've never seen Modeste looking so many times at once. as she gives the vote of thanks, we would ask that we get an opportunity to view the body. We want to give the immediate family first preference, and then followed by close relatives and all his special friends, if we can have that done at this time, please. Thank you. Good morning again, everyone. Afternoon now. thank you all for coming. Whether we be direct family, extension family, 29ers, St. Augustine group, customs group, the rhythm section, really helpful. Thank you, those who are viewing online. Thank you for coming out. Thank you for blessing us with your presence. Thank you for being here with us. Stay strong for us. Remember us as always in your prayers. And you know, keep on being strong for us at this time. Thank you to our dear cousin for coming and bless us with the word. And the moderator, AP Toussaint, thank you for being here. Musicians, thank you for supporting us. Yeah, everyone, whoever I left out. Jesus Elam Revival International, my family. Thank you, ushers. Thank you so much. All my friends who came, friends of ours, all the siblings, I love you. Jamel, I love you. Devon, I love you. In Victorine, I love you too. Thank you, tech guy, from audio guy. Thank you for being here. Marcus, thank you so much. While we're viewing the body, we're going to play the last video of the song that my dad sang with the 79ers on the Sunday. While we just hear it. Thanks again.
Okay, praise God. I'm going to hand over to our lovely host for today. Did she do a great job or did she do a great job? Yes? Minister A.B. Toussaint, thank you so much. I just want to just acknowledge, I'm not certain, of exactly who's here in terms of titles or ranks, so please, if anyone we left out,
please forgive us. We didn't have noticed before, but all you distinguished gentlemen, all you distinguished ladies, we really, and I'm looking at everybody now because it'd be like, oh, I'm over here, okay. All the distinguished ladies, all the distinguished men, if there are any ministers in our midst, ministers of religion, ministers of government, please, please know that we do love you and we acknowledge you. This is on behalf of the family, okay? Bless you all so good.
Thank you. So we would invite the family to view the body of our dearly beloved Patrick, and then everyone else can follow. Please allow the family to come now. After the family has come up front, we will depend on the ushers to guide the rest of us to be.
Hey.
Is everything all right?
Yeah, you know it is.
Very good to meet you. Yeah, it's a...
That's you. That's you.
Thank you.
That's what it's like.
Forasmuch as it has pleased the Almighty God to take out of the world the soul of Patrick Leslie Modeste, and to wait for the general resurrection of the dead, the righteous unto eternal life and the unrighteous unto damnation, we therefore commit his body, earth to earth, dust to dust, ashes to ashes, waiting for the rapture of the church when the dead in Christ shall rise first. Let's proceed. Proceed, yeah, yeah.
Oh, okay.
by my Father's hand. All my days I will sing in praise of your forest, the water, your shining sand. I hope the day would never come that I can't awake to the sound of drums. Never let me miss Carnival with Calypso songs philosophical. Oh, island in the sun, willed to me by my Father's hand. All my days I will sing in praise of your forest, your waters, your shining sand.
One more.
Oh, island in the sun, willed to me by my Father's hand. All my days I will sing in praise of your forest, your waters, your shining sand. Kumbaya, Lord, kumbaya, kumbaya, Lord, kumbaya, kumbaya, Lord, kumbaya, oh Lord, kumbaya. Patrick gone, Lord, kumbaya, Patrick gone, Lord, kumbaya. Patrick's gone, Lord, kumbaya, oh Lord, kumbaya. Take him in your arms, kumbaya. Take him in your arms, kumbaya. Take him in your arms, kumbaya, oh Lord, kumbaya. I'm going to leave my burden down by the riverside, down by the riverside, down by the riverside. I'll leave my burden down by the riverside, and I'll carry them no more. I will not 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 carry them no more. Across the bridge, there's no more sorrow. Across the bridge, there's no more pain. The sun will shine across the river, and you'll never be unhappy again. I have lived a life of sin in this world I'm living in. I've done forbidden things I shouldn't do. I asked a beggar along the way if he could tell me where to stay, where I can find happiness and love that's true. Across the bridge, there's no more sorrow. Across the bridge, there's no more pain. Sun will shine across the river, and you'll never be unhappy again. So put a little more oil in my lamp, keep it burning. A little more oil in my lamp, I pray. A little more oil in my lamp, keep it burning. Keep it burning recovery. A little more oil in my lamp, keep it burning. A little more oil in my lamp, I pray. A little more oil in my lamp, keep it burning. Keep it burning till it breaks of day. You could sign my name up there. Sign my name up there. Touch my finger with a golden pen, a golden pen, a golden pen. Touch my finger with a golden pen, sign my name up there. I am under the rock is higher than I. Jehovah hide me, I am under the rock. Go tell my enemies, I am under the rock. Jehovah hides me, I am under the rock. Oh yes, I am under the rock is I am. Jehovah has me, I am under the rock. Who tell my enemies, I am under the rock. Jehovah has me, I am under the rock. Oh, amen, 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 amen,
amen. That's only a part, yes. That's how it's police, yes, police. Not the whole choir, but we came from there, yeah?
Right. Representing the police choir.
Yeah, man. There is a candle in every soul. Body burden, some dark and cool. There is a spirit. Who brings the fire, ignites the candle, and makes its home. Carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the hopeless, deceived and poor. Hold out your candle for all to see. Take your candle, go light the world. Carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the lowly, deceived and worn. Hold out your candle for all to see. Take your candle, go light the world. Frustrated brother, see how he's tried to light his own candle some other way. See now your sister, she'd been robbed and lied to, still holds a candle without a flame. Carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the lowly, deceived and worn. Hold out your candle for all to see. Take your candle, go light the world. Carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the lowly, deceived and poor. Hold out your candle for all to see. Take your candle, go light the world. Take your candle, go light the world.
The man would appreciate a little kaiso, boy. Give him a little kaiso. All the way up to that. We all up to a little kaiso now, you know. All up to a little kaiso.
Plenty people in the world today to realize that worry don't pay. Plenty people in the world today to realize that worry don't pay. Putting the worries upon your shoulder, only bringing you older and older. Them wicked things, them people that do, they don't realize you have worries too. Tell them you never, never worry. Don't mind how things looking hard. Never, never worry. Even if you're suffering bad, never, never worry. What I'm saying is true. Anywhere you turn, somebody suffering more than you. When I was younger and easy to be, master boy, you must never worry. Your problem will seem bigger and bigger, and you'll be living a life of torture. She told me as a matter of fact, bring all my problems behind me back. Keep in touch with the Almighty for guidance, peace, and stability.
And abide with us both now and until Jesus come, and let everyone say amen.
My soul, my Savior, Lord, to thee. Go ahead. If you have to do something. That's fine. Good. Right.
Boy. You can see boy. Boy. Yeah. And you are alone here now. That's the end of the era. Glorious that my heart
to a life peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my knees.